knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
We just introduced phylum Arthropoda and some of its general characteristics, but this is an absolutely massive phylum, so it will take many tutorials to get through it all. Before diving into any specific clade, let's first perform an overview of the arthropod subphyla and wrap things up with a discussion of the extinct subphylum Trilobitomorpha. Though arthropods vary greatly and their diversity is unmatched, it is relatively easy to identify body plans associated with particular groups. There are traditionally considered to be 5 arthropod subphyla, though their relationship to each other and even the relevance of the subphyla is now being reconsidered. Traditionally, the 5 arthropod subphyla were Trilobitomorpha, which is the only entirely extinct arthropod subphylum, the trilobites. Chelicerata, which contains the spiders, ticks, horseshoe crabs, and their relatives. Myriapoda, which includes the centipedes, millipedes, and their relatives. Crustacea, which includes lobsters, crabs, barnacles, and many others. And finally, hexapoda, which includes the insects and entognathans. There are some potential problems with these subphyla. First, the current consensus is that there are just 2 extant arthropod subphyla. Chelicerata, a sister taxon to all other arthropods, and Mandibulata, which includes Myriapoda and Pancrustacea. Subphylum Crustacea is actually paraphyletic according to more recent studies, and Hexapoda is actually nested within Crustacea, so that the two actually form a clade known as Pancrustacea, which should be split into the clades Ostracoda, Copepoda, Brachiapoda, and Hexapoda. In this series, we will recognize Mandibulata and Pancrustacea, while also using the common term crustacean to refer to all pancrustaceans except for Hexapoda, keeping a bit more with the traditional classification for ease of understanding. Another issue is the exact placement of subphylum Trilobitomorpha, or Trilobita. We will refer to them as the sister taxon to all extant arthropods, but this placement has drawn some recent controversy that places the trilobites essentially between Chelicerata and Myriapoda. 4 of the 5 arthropod subphyla, Chelicerata, Myriapoda, Hexapoda, and Crustacea, contain a massive diversity of extant species, and we will explore them in more detail shortly. However, since Trilobitomorpha contains only extinct arthropods, let's cover them briefly now. The trilobites, whose name means 3 lobes and is a reference to the trilobed shape of the body in cross-section, are a clade of entirely extinct marine arthropods that form the class Trilobita. They first appear in the fossil record in the early Cambrian about 521 million years ago, and initially flourished before a long decline and eventual extinction in the mass extinction event that occurred at the end of the Permian period about 252 million years ago. They were dorsally flattened bottom dwellers with unique compound eyes made of rigid crystalline lenses. Like modern arthropods, the trilobites came in a staggering diversity of forms, mainly due to modifications of segments and fringes, and some even had tridents, whose roles are not yet fully understood. There are currently 22,000 species of described trilobites, though their total species count is likely much higher considering their clade existed for more than 269 million years. Like modern arthropods, their exoskeletons contained chitin and was strengthened in some areas by calcium carbonate. They had 3 body segments, or tagmata, the cephalon, or head, trunk, and pygidium. Most had a pair of antennae, eyes which were sometimes stalked,
and many pairs of legs.
Many also appeared to be able to curl into a ball, like modern pill bugs, when threatened or stimulated. They were likely extremely important in ancient seas, ecologically speaking, and their fossils were used to develop the concept of punctuated equilibrium. Today, their fossils are still being discovered around the world, and they are used as stratigraphic markers of the Cambrian period. So that concludes an introduction to the subphyla of Arthropoda. As you can see, there's quite a bit more to discuss with this phylum, and we will be going over the diversity and morphology of each of the other four subphyla in quite a bit more detail. Let's move forward and examine the form and function of chelicerates next.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.